as a child, I did see how we're struggling to maybe get a little piece of places, especially after dry season, to do irrigation. And also living in the off-grid community, I could also see what sources we were using by that time. So when I grew up and I did a little bit of studies in the same area of energy, I said, no, I think I have to be part of the solution, not to be part of the problem. That drove me to found the company that we call Green Impact Technologies today.
Green Impact Technologies, GIT, is providing sustainable farming solutions to support smallholder farmers to increase their productivity and adapt to climate change. These solutions include affordable solar water pumps, organic fertilizers, and solar fridges.
If you look at Sub-Saharan Africa as a whole, we have over 400 million off-grid households. Malawi alone, we have got 20 million people. Over 80% are off-grid, and these people are not powered with the energy for powering appliances, whether it's cooking, lighting, phone charging, and even for farming. So for me, I am working in that niche. That's my target market. So we are providing climate smart agriculture technologies, solar irrigation, as well as solar fridges. So these are used for, especially for the farmers. Once they harvest, they're able to store their produce in horticulture in the solar fridges so that they can sell them maybe in the next day. And also the irrigation systems are used for farming. We have got one season that comes between December up to March. That's why we target these subsistence farmers. So during this period, they should be able to grow the crops the same way they do during rainy season. So in some way, we are trying to break the cycle of harvest season. Instead of having one season, we want them to grow throughout the year. They're able to provide water for about 3,600 liters in a day. So one can use it for almost a hectare.
The pumps are sold using the pay-as-you-go business model, where the farmers can pay for the pumps in installments.
Komano atabwela Green Impact atalumikizana ndi aboma alangizatu kuti patsamwayo tino anatibwereka pump imene tinaitenga pangongole imene ne kuti thandizira panopo mulimi wathu chifano kutsirira kwathu tikatenga pump ija timatsirira ndithu wane akatikhozotsirira imene ne kuti thandizira kuti tikathira malo akulu ndaye uzathuso tikhozogulitsa zochuluka zimene tingapeze phindu lochuluka limene ne kuti tikhozotithandizira kumabweza ngongole imene tilinayo ya pump imene tikugwiritsa ntchito.
Kale mmene timagwiritsa ntchito mauta keni timatenga nthawi itali tikugwira ntchito sitimapangaso zina ayi zoti zimatithandizira pa moyo wathu tikumagwiritsa ntchito mapampuwa timathirira kwa nthawi yochepa ndikumaliza malo akulu kuna kunda kumakapanga zina.
Then in terms of the staff from Green Impact Technology, we have got an agronomist. He helps them how they can grow high value crops or horticultural products.
Actually, I work with smaller farmers here in Incheon, training them in good agricultural practices like nitrogen management, weeding, pest and disease management, fertilizer application, and many more. As of now, we have reached 291 farmers, but our main aim is to reach at least 1,000 farmers by the end of this year.
GIT also supports farmers in collecting and distributing their produce to different wholesalers in Malawi.
Our business development manager now goes to these off-takers and they strike off-taker agreements. Using the truck that you have seen outside, we're able to get all that to the off-takers, whether it's Pico Plus, ShopLite, Food Lovers. That's how we do it, to make sure that after they sell, then they're able to get back their money.
GIT scope of work does not stop at irrigation. It has commenced a biogas project that not only provides alternative cooking energy, but also manufactures organic fertilizer that will boost food production.
Malawi has got the highest deforestation rate, it's about 2.2. So in the markets where we have developed these biogas plants, we are providing gas for cooking. That's the number one, as a solution to address issues of deforestation and lack of alternative energy for cooking. Number two, it's the opportunity for waste management. And then number three is the high cost of inorganic fertilizers. So from the biogas, because we produce liquid fertilizer, they're able to use it for farming for various crops that they are selling.
Kaimene ndi kuthira fertilizer ndikakolola marumba ocheva kumapano ndakolola kumarumba ochuluka pafufupi mwina 20 ndi ndikuona kusiyanitsa kwa fertilizer ndi bwezela nthaka ameneyi ndikuona kuti chaka chino ndapindula.
Green Impact Technologies is currently putting final touches on a one-stop energy center that will be used for training and also serve as an information center for smallholder farmers.
The e-hub is a one-stop shop. So like for the farmers we work with, they come at the hub, they are trained in terms of extension, how they can grow high-value crops, how they can access market, and a little bit of financial literacy. 5 years from now, we want to get to almost 100,000 farmers and communities that we have reached to with our innovations. I was only one in 2017 with the idea. But today I'm talking about, we have got 16 full-time staff. These are young graduates that have graduated from the university. Some of them, they have come in, being trained and growing. We also have 40 agents that we have employed. So job creation, solutions that we provide to the communities, and the impact in general that we are doing motivates us to keep going.